There's 104 days of summer vacation, and school comes along just to end it. So the annual problem for our generation is finding a good way to spend it.
Like maybe
building a rocket or fighting a mummy or climbing up the Eiffel Tower. Discovering something that doesn't exist,
hey,
or giving a monkey a shower. Surfing tidal waves, creating nanobots, or locating Frankenstein's brain.
It's over here!
Finding a dodo bird, painting a continent, or driving our sister insane!
Idiot!
As you can see, there's a whole lot of stuff to do before school starts this fall.
Come on, Barry!
So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all! So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all!
Mr. Witt, they're filming another intro again.
Buenos dias, Nipher!
And bonjour!
Me amo Amelia.
And je m'appelle Jamie. Today is National School Principal Day.
Make sure to thank Dr. Havener, Dr. Dickinson, and Dr. Ruta for all their hard work today.
I love all of our school principals, but I also love America! So put your hands over your heart, Nipher, for the pledge!
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Have you seen the new ducks and chickens around Nipher?
I have, but I want to learn more.
Well, perfect. Let's go to me and Liam for more about our new feathery friends.
Miss Laxton's room at Nipher is a home to baby ducklings.
What's it like having ducks as a class pet?
They are very messy, but they're cute.
What is going to happen to the ducks once they're more grown up?
Mr. Banizak is going to take them to his sister's farm in Michigan.
At first, the embryo inside the egg can use oxygen from outside. The eggshell is built to collect oxygen from outside the egg, so the embryo can continue to grow inside the egg until it is ready to hatch. At any point in this process, the egg can be held up to a flashlight to see if the embryo is still doing well inside the egg. When the embryo is big enough that the oxygen from the outside of the egg is not enough, the duckling pecks a hole through the egg. This allows the duckling to build up the strength to hatch out of the egg hours or even days later.
Also, Mr. Banizak has baby chicks in his classroom.
What's it like having baby chicks in your classroom?
It is a little bit of distraction. It's often hard to focus, even for me, when we're doing something like reading or writing, but most kids are handling it really well.
After an egg has been laid by the mother, it takes 21 days of incubation to hatch. Incubation is when the mother sits on the egg for roughly 24 hours per day to provide the correct hatching conditions. After pecking its way through the egg, the chick begins to grow rapidly. They nearly double their size in the first 2 weeks after hatching. 20 weeks after hatching, they reach their full size.
Everyone, make sure you turn in all of your library books by May 16th. Eighth graders, you must turn in your library books and any lost materials by this date, or else there will be a fine that will follow you to high school.
Oh, high school. I'm so excited to go to Kirkwood High School next year. What about you?
Me too. There are so many options for sports.
Yeah. Speaking of high school sports, the football and basketball coaches from Kirkwood High School will be at Nipher to meet with the 8th grade boys interested in playing basketball or football in high school.
Coach Macklin and Coach Taylor will be here tomorrow on Thursday, May 2nd, during homeroom in the library.
6th graders, keep up the great work in math testing. You guys are so smart.
I wonder if there's any staff members here that are smarter than all of us middle schoolers. Let's go to Are You Smarter Than a Middle Schooler with Noah, Kate, and Elle to find out.
Two people will be competing against each other in this game.
There will be three questions that they will have to answer.
We will explain the question, and the first person to hit the red button in front of them will get to answer first.
Okay, ready?
I'm here with our first competition, and this is...
Martha. Miss Evers.
And what grade are you in?
Eighth grade.
And what do you teach?
I teach reading to all grades.
And what is Earth located in? Like, which galaxy? What?
I'm gonna... wait a minute. Is it the Milky Way?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not our second question. What is the most consumed beverage after water?
Coffee. Like, oh, you go first.
Coffee.
No.
It should be Diet Coke, but I don't think it is. So, milk?
No.
Tea?
Tea! Yes. Oh, it's tea, all those British people.
Okay. For our third question, we have, what is the most widely spoken language in South America?
Spanish?
That is correct. Wait, that one is not. We're here with our second contest, and this is...
Emma.
And...
Miss Midkiff.
And what grade are you in?
I'm in sixth.
And what do you teach?
I teach eighth grade science.
And for our first question, how many letters are in the alphabet?
26.
Yes. For our second question, we have, how many countries are in North America?
I'm not going to New York.
Three.
What?
You're like a science teacher.
No, you're right. It's three.
I'm not good with geography.
I was overthinking.
Okay, ready? For our second question, we have, what are the first 10 amendments of the Constitutional Rights called?
The Bill of Rights?
Maybe. What month has 28 days in it?
February.
Yeah.
Woo! Dang it.
So I'm here with our third competition, and this is...
Ms. Schneider.
And...
Declan.
And what do you teach?
I teach Spanish.
And what grade are you in?
Oh, sixth grade.
Okay, and the first question will be, Mount Everest is located on the border of Nepal in what country?
India.
That's incorrect.
Oh. South Africa?
China.
That's correct. For our second question, name two of the three major mountain ranges in the U.S.
The Appalachians and the Rockies.
Yes. For our third question, we have, how many countries are in North America?
Eleven.
That's incorrect.
Six.
That's also incorrect.
Four?
No.
Seven?
Eight.
Incorrect.
No. 13?
No.
24?
You're going the wrong way.
Three?
Yeah.
Is it Canada, Mexico, and United States?
Yeah.
That's what I was going to say.
What about the
Well, that's all we have for you today, Nipher.
Make sure you like this lit video
and subscribe to this lit channel.
And remember,
you belong in Nipher!